The author is, simply, a person who wrote a story. He or she is the originator or creator of his or her work. Therefore, he or she has the authority to do what he or she wants in the story. In poetry, the author is called the poet. For example, American poet Edgar Allan Poe, who wrote Annabel Lee, English poet Samuel Taylor Coleridge, who wrote The Rime of Ancient Mariner, and the other American poet Robert Frost, who wrote The Road Not Taken, the author is different from narrator. Although, physically, both of them are the same, conceptually both are different. Narrator is a person who tells a story. A narrator only exists in a fiction or in a poem. A narrator may be a character in the text, however, the narrator does not have to be a character in the text. The main point of a narrator is to narrate a story, that is, to tell a story. What the narrator can and cannot see determines the perspective of the text and also determines how much the reader knows. The narrator is an integral part of a story. Although he or she may or may not be a character in a story, the narrator develops his or her own voice. The way the author describes the narrator determines how the text is received by the reader. If the narrator is portrayed well, the book will be well written, and vice versa. A good narrator makes the reader want to continue reading the text. A good narrator makes the reader feel like he's completely immersed in the storyline and the life of the characters. In poetry, a narrator is called also a speaker, for in poetry the narrator often speaks his or her thought rather than narrate the story. Let's take a look at the example in Poe's Annabel Lee. This poem is narrated by a boy who is Annabel Lee's lover, who strongly condemns the people and supernatural beings who try to obstruct their love. In the end, the speaker claims that his love with Annabel Lee is so strong that, even after her death, they are still together. Different from the narrator of Poe's Annabel Lee, who speaks his thought, the narrator in Coleridge's The Rime of Ancient Mariner narrates a story. This poem is told by an unnamed third-person narrator. He is an old mariner who shares his story with the wedding guest. He delivers a narrative at the beginning and the end of the poem. The voices of wedding guests and sailors are written as dialogue with quotation marks in the body of the third-person point of view. In this poem, there are two levels of narrative, the story of the mariner and the wedding guest, and the story within a story of the mariner's voyage, which takes up most of the poem. While in the last poem, Frost's The Road Not Taken is narrated from a first-person viewpoint, the speaker explains events that happened to him, using I, to describe himself. This viewpoint makes the reader to fully understand the thoughts and actions of the characters. Thanks for watching. Sakeon. Done, Thierry Marcassi.